Hey, Ken Obasi Leslie again. This is part two of the video that I'm doing this pastel rendering of Chadwick Boseman. And I got my music going. I got my coffee over here. And here we go. As you can see, I sort of made some advancement and finding out I'm at the point now where I am just putting the pastel renderings straight on the piece, just like I have this brown here, and it's just you kind of give it whatever you need to give it. I know if you kind of notice in the background, I got a little music playing. I got some Charlie Parker happening right now. I always love what he's doing, and there's Sebasti's is back up there on top of the easel again. She's making sure that I get things right here. Now I have something of kind of a purple here, and so I'm gonna put some of that in here from, just to kind of give it a little highlight, it's just that, now see, cause you're at the point of being able to just do what you want to do. And it's just that I love fusing colors together. I love just kind of what you might say, fusing colors that you would not think would be part of the image. It's just that because there are sometimes colors that you don't really see or perceive, and but those colors that you don't see or perceive, are very important to bringing out the image. Now, hopefully I will be able to give justice to this rendering, but I'm I do it my way, I'm gonna put a little gray in here. Actually, I'm putting a little gray in the hair here, because what's going to happen is, as I deal with the hair, I might put a little gray in the beard down here, Okay, I'm not gonna do too much of it. And but as you can see, it is starting to come together as a color composition. The more yellow, just kind of get that yellow in there. You know, because what's going to happen is, you know, you're going to have to, when we start bringing out the highlights, and, you know, and again, like, you know, said, everything doesn't have to be all perfect, but what we're doing is rendering, you know, a portrait of the highlights of, you know, who he is, you know. And sometimes, you know, when you use color, a lot of color, you know, you actually bring out more of the spirit of a situation, of a portrait, you know. Now, what I have here, right here, is black, and I think at this point in time, we could start using black, you know, because basically we have basically done the whole face with a mixture of different colors and everything, you know. So I'm gonna start using a little black on the hair, and start bringing the hair out, as you can see. And again, you know, I'm not really too concerned with everything being all perfect, you know. You know, I mean, because perfection will, it will develop, you know. I'm going to use some of this black down here in the beard. And, you know, start to bring the beard out a little bit. And here we go. And kind of shape the beard, you know, because here we go there. And, you know, and again, you know, we could you know, keep shaping the beard, you know, I mean, you know, you could just shape the beard in any way you want to, you know, just to make sure. Because, you know, because like a lot of times, you know, you know, again, working with pastels is, I can almost say it, working with pastels is like molding. You know, it's like, it's almost like sculpture, you know. I mean, you know, you're giving it you know, you're creating a shape. And here we go. And trying to get the balance here, so it would be all balanced out, you know. And add a little bit more to the hair, and get that hair, yeah, okay. And now, you know, and one of the things that you know, because I usually do the eyes last, you know. I mean, you know, when I could, I can kind of see what needs to be done. Now, I'm going to put a little black down here, shaping the lips. And the lips may need shaping a little bit more, you know, and and another thing is his nostrils. And now we're just kind of working in, you know, some shapes, and it's kind of you know, there's a little shadow underneath here, and okay, and now that his eyes are, of course, it's a little, I have to be careful here because I don't want to get things, get his eyes out of kilter. This is giving little eyebrows here. Yeah, and the eyebrows don't have to be all perfect. You know, you're still sort of working with, now, I mean, I hope you can see what I'm doing here, you know, and how I'm doing this. Now, I'm going to take a little rag, and I'm going to start, at certain places, taking off some of the pastel. Just start giving it a little highlight here and there. And, as you can see, a little highlight there. And see what I'm doing there. And actually, you know, instead of using, well, because sometimes the rag is, or the towel or whatever you want to use to do the highlight is too big, so you might want to cut it. You know, just cut it down so that you know, as you can see, so it's like small, and you can, you know, kind of control things a little bit more, you know. And there's a little highlight up here, a little highlight up there. see what I'm doing here. Okay, and as I can see that I can see that I may need to work with his, you know, his face a little bit so everything is basically symmetrical. And and then down on his lips, yeah, there's this little highlight, you know, and let's see, where else does he have a little highlight? Mm-hmm. There's a little bit of highlight right in here, but not, I don't want to do too much. Yeah, little bit of highlight right in here. I don't want to do too much. And got something going on over here. Now, see, I can take my fingers and start molding some of this color together. You know, as I said, that it becomes a lot like sculpture. And let's see, my music. Why didn't you tell me? Sebastian, the music is, you can see what Sebastian's up there, you know, just checking out the piece, you know, and she's like my little overseer, and, let's see, I'm gonna turn over Charlie Parker. And basically, the piece is an old album called Bebop. And, you know, I mean, it's pretty classic, you know, Charlie Parker, Bebop. You know, this is done actually in 1955. And, you know, it's a hot house, Boop Bop She Bam. You know, I've got all those tunes on there. But, okay, back to the, now I've got the basic highlights. Now, you know, now I like to take my chances, you know. I like to kind of do my thing, and here's like a little blue, and I'm gonna put a little bit of that. Actually, it's a turquoise or whatever you want to call it, but it's gonna go into the beard. Creating another kind of thing that's happening This is kind of like a turquoise, a green. And, but it's, I kind of like it. You know, I like what it's doing. And, a little bit. Here we go. Put a little bit over here. Okay. And I hope you can actually see what I'm doing. Yeah. You need to put a little bit over here. Bring that nose. Now, you know, I mean, there are some things that, you know, when you're using pastels or whatever, you know, it's just that sometimes I like to mix a little ink or with my pastels, kind of give it that, you know, well, what happens is there are little parts that deserve, because, like, you know, as you can see, the pastels are, you know, pretty thick, you know, and there are things that you need to do in order to you know, to make them to be able to get the effect and get some of the things that you need to get. You know, and there we go, there, and okay, and a little bit to the hair, yeah, and okay, now. His sweater, he has a turtleneck on, and we're going to give that turtleneck a little attention. And again, you know, as you can see, you know, I like to, you know, I like to see what everything's gonna look like, you know. So a lot of times, I may work pretty fast. Yeah. Yeah, this is actually a turtleneck sweater that he has on, and as much as I can give it some justice, and as you can see. Again, I'm like, just, you know, just working in some colors, and again, you're with Obasi, and you know, it's just that doing art with Obasi. And Sebastian's. And, okay. Working in that turtleneck. Let's see what else can we really do with it. And then, you know, around. there's going to be some deviation of color. And I'm putting, this is kind of like a violet that a lot of times, you know, it's just that, you know, and I make color choices very spontaneously. And you know, it just sometimes it just comes to me, and then boom, you know, I've already made a choice. And as you can see, he's starting to come out a little bit. Now, this is the delicate part here. Gotta be his eyes. And as you can see, I'm using a pencil to kind of pencil in his eyes before I actually before I actually put them in. As you can hear in the background, Charlie Parker, and my man on trumpet, actually a lineup. But anyhow, let's see. Okay. Now, there are, of course, some other things that need to go in. Kind of put a little bit of the eyelid there. You know. And this is one of the things I do, cause like I use a magic marker to kind of color in the eyes. There we go. And His eyes are a little more, not too wide, but you know, the name that I was trying to think of is Dizzy Gillespie. Yeah, and I'm trying to shape in this nose. Hopefully it's gonna look something like Bozeman. Trying to get as much of his likeness as I can. Obasi. We've gotten this far with the piece, and let's kind of work with these ears a little bit, you know. And a lot of times, you know, I work it so far, and then I'll call myself finished. Problem using different mediums. Here, I'm gonna put a little highlight on his eyeballs. And then sometimes you just use paint. to just to get whatever you want to get. And all right. Well, again, I just want to thank you for painting with me. And again, you know, this is something that I'm doing that's new. And I hope you enjoyed watching his face develop. And and we'll keep doing this from time to time, and we'll have some fun. So this is Ken Obasi Leslie, and you're doing art with Ken Obasi. Thank you.